Baker. It's a gorgeous Friday evening. Nice and sunny, a little bit of cloud around, 90 degrees out here. Bit toasty, but welcome to the broadcast for 11 Sports and the WPSL for Chattanooga FC hosting Nashville Rhythm FC here at Finley. Great to have you along for the ride, and I'm Simon Neal. I'll be taking care of you today during the whole game, and we'll bring you all 90 minutes of action and all the goals, all the excitement, all the controversy, all the stuff you get in great WPSL soccer. The teams are taking the field right now. I'll bring you the lineup shortly. Quick note on the key points of the game tonight. Obviously looking for Chattanooga FC not to concede quite as many goals as they did against Nashville at the home game a month ago, and to hold their own on this one. It's going to be tough for Chattanooga, no doubt about it, because Nashville at the top of the table with a goal difference of, I think it's 20 or 22, plus 22, so it's pretty intense. They've got some good goal scorers on board, so make sure we can defend them. The coach has put out a 3-3-4 formation for Chattanooga, Coach Randy Douglas, so I hope that will take care of business. So we will see what happens tonight. Chattanooga, of course, in the all sky blue, and Nashville in the look at the black with a half sky blue stripe on their shirt, which is very nice. Kind of a half a hoops. I think that's rather fetching. They have some good looking uniforms at Nashville. So anybody cheering in tonight from Davidson County, thank you for joining us and watching, and we appreciate that. Glad to have you on board to watch the game here in Finley Stadium. Only a short drive down the freeway, so hope you can come and see a game here sometime. It's not that far from Nashville. So Karen's hooting, we've got a little radio-controlled Volkswagen car there. He's hooting about that. Let's give it to starting 11s. Head coach Scott Davison has brought his Nashville team down. His starting 11, number 37, Amber Barnett. Number 28, Ellie Belcher. Number 30, Rebecca Campbell. 31, Peyton DePriest. 34, Maddie Elbro. 25, Molly Grant. Number 7, Keto Ido, who is their main goal scorer. Number 9, Amika Karagishi. Number 12, Angela Steidel. Number 27, Brenna Swag, and on top, number 10, Yuki Watari. Be watching out for Keto and for Yuki, who are their big goal scorers. Now here's Chattanooga starting lineup. Coach Reddy Douglas has put out a good team tonight, a couple of changes. Number 5, Alexa Avery. Number 7, Isabel Aguilar. Number 8, Sierra Root in the midfield, alongside Sierra Bowl. Number 10, Natalie Villalobos in the holding midfield. Hannah Lounter, the captain in defence, number 14. 18, Caroline Johnson in goal. Number 19, Rocio Carrizales. Next to number 20, Jasmine Marquez. And then 15, Anna Silver in defence. And 31, Kaylee Burrell. We'll be underway momentarily off the national anthem and the officials bump fists with the players, of course, and looking forward to a great game tonight. So it's not quite as hot as last weekend when the ladies played and they had to wait an hour because of the extreme heat. Although I think we'll see quite a lot of water breaks during this game, as it is still pretty toasty down there at even this time of night, still very hot. And as we come in towards the end of June, it always gets hot, so no surprises there. Thank you. grass out of the way, and then we'll be up and running. Don't forget, if you want to get the season ticket, still plenty of time to get tickets for the men's and the women's games. Although this is the last women's game here at Finley this season, there are a couple of away games that the men's still playing right through until the end of October and November. So plenty of games to go and see. Go to CFC Tix, that's TIX.com, to pick up your season ticket or your passes or your passes you can use any time. So it's a good place to come. Listen to me on the broadcast. You can come down and see a game for yourself and enjoy the great atmosphere in Finley Stadium. I've got to say thanks to our sponsor tonight, Louisiana Hot Sauce, who is sponsoring the game, and thanks to them for their generous support. So this is a return leg after the game a month ago. As I said earlier, we lost, unfortunately, took 5 goals in against Nashville in their home game, and the only consolation was Brianna Smotherman getting a goal for CFC on the return on that game. Next up, we're away on Sunday to TN Force in Knoxville, and then the last game of the season is on Saturday, July 2nd, away to North Alabama SC. So a couple more ladies' games within driving distance that are worth going to go and see. They'd love your support, I know, and we should always support women's sports. This is a great way to do it. At the present time, Nash Rhythm are looking very strong, top of the table in the WPSL South on 13 points. Tennessee Force FC from Knoxville, 1 point behind them on 12. Alabama FC on 10, then right below that, I'm afraid. Chattanooga Cerny on 3, and North Alabama bring up the rear with 0. So a chance for Chattanooga to win some games, maybe go up the table a couple of spots, but they're going to have to really pull out all the stops and start scoring some goals to let that happen. I'm sure they will do that tonight, and I have great confidence in these ladies, who are a good-looking team. So, but say Nash Rhythm currently dominant with that plus 22 goal difference is kind of hard to argue with. So we'll see how they do tonight, and see if they add to that or they ship some goals. You're watching out for, as I said, Keita Ido, number 7, who's down there on the left wing. She's the number 1 goal scorer for them with 9, and then number 10 Yuki Watari with 6. Number 10. So also Molly Grant on 4 and Reagan Kelly on 4 as well, on 4 goals as well. On 3 goals, sorry. So they'll be looking to add some goals too, but watch out for the Japanese ladies. They'll be the ones who'll be making the dangerous plays during this game. About to get underway. Referee's about to blow the whistle. I think he's happy everything's where it should be. So relax, get comfortable, and we'll bring you the whole game any moment now. Kicking off. keeps it in play. Looking for a bit of support. Chattanooga defending strongly here and clearing it out. Only Beltran able to come away with that one. And Lanta doing the magic. For a gap, long ball, it could be out. I think it's going to run out. No, they're going to keep it in. Again, Nash all very aggressive from the off, not holding back here. Now Chattanooga's chance for the break. See, they got the other weather. Great ball. Here we go. Oh, good save. Now the long shot. Oh, nice try goes wide. Chattanooga making the break there. And two good strikes to make the keeper catch her breath and go, wait a minute. Good play from Chattanooga there. First of the ball all the time here. Just going to keep that up during the entire game, trying to go for the break. Back to the keeper, not a great pass. Warbeck get back and it slides out for a corner to Nashville. First corner of the game to Nashville. Not a super pass back. Shot and Optimistic drifts off to the right. Every gets a chance to reset there. Lex Avery, the lone striker for Chattanooga, made a good break there. Just able to slide that shot past the keeper, but I think she'll get some more as the game goes on. Nashville back possession again. Slips out for a goal kick. Caroline Johnson playing it short there. Chattanooga looking to push out. Nashville very much in their faces in the Chattanooga half most of the game so far, trying to squeeze in that early goal. They're cleared out, they're bobbling around the box a bit too much for comfort. Alexa Avery steams after that one. She's got the ball, has she got the support? She has not, and that gets pushed out for a throw-in to Chattanooga. Playing up for Nashville, number 31. They're looking to set her off, as well as Keto Ido being the target ladies for Nashville at the moment. Playing a lot down this left wing too. Is it a bit too much? I think too much on it. Yeah, she lets that one go. This one slips out for another goal kick to Chattanooga. Lex Avery chasing again, but cleaned up Rebecca Campbell. Now she'll play in the back four, the same as Chattanooga are. A bit of a sloppy pass there, but hey, it's early. Randy Douglas really on his feet, urging on his players to stick to the system and the formation he's told them to do, and working well so far. Scott Davis is more relaxed on the National Rhythm bench. He's sitting there watching the game like he's watching a bit of snooker or something, or the tennis at Wimbledon. He's quite relaxed. Actually, Scott Davis has a little connection. He went to Bryan College to get his degree after playing in Scottish and the US leagues for a couple of years. So he's definitely got a Chattanooga connection by going to Bryan. We call a lot of our ex-players who ended up. Tom Olsen and Luke Winter are there, of course. Now, here's the break on. Cross the ball. And that's the first goal off the right-hand post. National looking for that mistake in Chattanooga's defence and able to take advantage of it, pinging it off the right-hand post into the back of the goal there. Matari Yuki with the cross. See that again, that replay. And actually it deflects off the Chattanooga defenders almost. Yeah, Peyton DePriest with the goal, the assist from number 10, Yuki Watari. Chattanooga ready on the back foot after just 8 minutes of play. Too far. Amber Barnett running the midfield and making sure there's somebody on the far side to receive the ball. Chattanooga need to get this marking a little tighter. Stop them making as much room as they can to pass the ball out. And the goalkeeper Chattanooga, certainly the pressure is all on from Nashville, which is the style they've played and what's kept them at the top of the table is that pressing style. It's working, so they aren't going to change it. Chattanooga need to find something to counter that a bit and hit them on the break if they can. A good steal there by Watari. Ball back into play fast. Sierra Bowl now down the left right wing. Puts it out for Chattanooga to throw. Let me throw again a little bit rushing on Chattanooga's part here. Seems to be a bit of a hurry to get moving rather than just taking their time. Alexa Avery now coming down the right wing. She's got two on her. Can she get past two? She needs some support. Who's there? Pass to not how she wanted to get it. And Kawagishi cleaning up. And Kawagishi again looking to spread the ball across to the right wing. She'll try and come down the right side. That one goes out for a Chattanooga throw again. Hope you can hear the chat. Hooligans start. They're in good voice, making lots of noise. Always supporting the ladies and men's team, whatever's going on. Now, Nashville coming again, trying to get the cross in. Good clean up there. Watari getting it across, but Anna Lanter to the rescue. Jumping Marquez under a bit of pressure. Give that away for a Nashville throw taken quickly. Good long ball. Looking for the keeper being off her line. Carolyn Johnson a bit off the line there, but no danger. chance to reset after this goal kick. Johnson quick to take these kicks straight away. She's in a hurry to get the ball away from her, I think. But Sam's the hurrying has given the ball away. In time and space to control the midfield a bit and pick the side they want to attack from. And they go again. Again, Hannah Lanza steals it back. Keeps it safe for Chattanooga. Can she keep it in? Just in play. But it's an absolute advantage, unfortunately. She tries to go through, no foul. Nope, play goes on, just a collision. Lex Ravery giving chase. But Angela Steidel there, taking it out, winning the throw for Nashville. Giveaway Sierra Bowl, looking for Avery. A bit too much on that, trickles back to the goalkeeper. But a good idea. Again, that's the break. Chapman are going to have to find those breaks. Set Alex Ravery off to attack. Good long ball, and that's right through to Ido. Comes in from the left wing. Back to Ido. Chapman will clean up nicely again. Cross, ball's loose. Dash Chattanooga cannot clear it, and that's the second goal. An individual effort. Ball was just bouncing around, like two defenders and the goalkeeper could not take care of that one. Peyton DePriest with her second goal of the evening in the 13th minute. For a shot just to the left of the goal, but again, defenders not closing that one down, giving them enough space to get the shot away. Molly Grant there trying to get in and get her name on the score sheet. Again, Chattanooga's clearance is a little something to be desired there, giving that one away too easily. Clearing it as far as Kalagishi in the midfield. Chattanooga again, giving a bit too much space to Nashville, and that's a foul. Anna Lanza on Peyton DePriest. Nobody hurt, just a coming together of feet and ankles. And it's a free kick from about 21, 22 yards out. Almost scoring distance. Let's see if Otara is going to have a shot or go through a drill. Here we go. Takes a shot. And over the top. Chattanooga. Another goal kick. It's like 15 minutes played in the first half. 2-0 down already. Chattanooga need to consolidate a bit and start looking for those breaks where they can get a goal back. Sneaks through. Another goal, and yep, that was onside. Yep, referee didn't call that one's offside. So number 25, Molly Grant, as I was saying earlier, trying to get herself on the scoreboard, and she did. Firmly in control of the game at this point. Chattanooga have a lot to do. Let's see what they've got in reserve. Good clearance there. Anna Silver to the rescue on that one. Goal kick. Good defending from Anne Silver again there. Yuki Watari trying to do all kinds of stuff to get around her. Chattanooga fans, the short kick, that's where the short goal kick is not a good idea and it can just backfire on you, and unfortunately it did again. Looks like Peyton DePriest getting her third. See that again. Just a mistake. Priest has time to catch it and turn around and take the shot. Chattanooga giving him just a bit too much room. There, what was going on. 21st minute of the game. We're taking a water break here, folks. So I suggest you do the same at home, take a little water break, and we'll be in action in about 2 minutes. Obviously a good chance for the coach to talk to the players and give them some tips and maybe change the plans or tactics, see if they can make a swing on this game, start getting some goals back. We will see what the coach has to say to them. Folks, chance for the players to fit on some water. It's still really hot down there, and the heat does come off that field. Even though the sun's going away, it's still reflected back out of that artificial surface. So, see if Chattanooga can have a little reset and get back into the game a bit more. And restart from where the referee blew the whistle. He blows it on the time, so it just. And the ball went out of play at a convenient time. He stopped it for the water breaks. Chattanooga to resume with a throw on the far side. It's a bad deflection. Good clean up from Chattanooga there. And that's offside. Nice try, but clearly offside. It's been nice to see that one. Caroline Johnson to take the spot kick. Off it goes. Chattanooga. Not winning any of those aerial battles just yet. They need to work on that a little bit, perhaps, too. And be there first for the aerial battles. Now Atlanta trying to break it away. And Silver taking care of that. No handball. Players going for a handball, but nothing happening. Now Chattanooga with a break. Here we go. Brianna Hurtado gets it. And forces Nashville to push it out. Quickly taken. Back into play. Hurtado, she's got two on to help her. MJ Park gets the cross in and straight to the keeper. A little bit of action for Maddie Elbro there. She hasn't been too busy the first part of the game. you want to be able to stop that getting through. It seems to work pretty well for Nashville. Now for Chattanooga to throw on the far side. Foul. This is a bit like what all goes down. Again, nobody hurt seriously, just coming together. There. Chattanooga, 12 coming on. Peter Chaco coming on. MJ Park coming off. Peter's a striker, so we'll see if she can put a little more bite into Chattanooga's attack. Also making substitutions. Looks like Kawagishi coming off. He's been controlling the midfield. Physical. Brenna Hurtado with it. She's going to take the free kick. Not hurt. Pinto Chaka going up to the front. See if she can do something like this goal difference. Like something Chattanooga rehearsed in practice. Let's see what we do. Deep into the box. Bit too strong and rolls out for a goal kick to Nashville. Nash has also taken off the Priest as well. I think she's earned her pay today with 3 goals in 15 minutes. So Molly Grant taking the attacking position the Priest had. Catch it. So that one's offside. They didn't catch that one, okay, because Molly Grant was offside there. They didn't catch the first one, went out here on the near side. But hey, maybe the sun's in their eyes. Chattanooga with a free kick from where the offside was committed. Hurtado heads it on. Bouncing around a little bit, Chattanooga able to keep it under control to the Nationals' benefit. They take the ball and slow it down a little bit. Obviously wanting to not run too much in this heat, don't blame them. It's a bit toasty out there still. Conserve a bit of energy for the rest of the game. Half an hour in now, still 4-0 to Nashville, sitting on that lead. And Caroline Johnson able to hoof that to safety. The Nashville throw deep in their half. Another substitution coming up for Nashville. Sarah Hammerstone coming on. to replace number 27, Brenna Swiger. Both teams have a good bench. There's five or six players on each bench, so they'll be rotating quite often during the ladies' games. A little hard for me to keep track of these things, being old and blind, but I'll do my best for you. Try and make sure I can catch them all as they come and go. In Chattanooga pushing out here. Clearances over national level to gather them up and make something out of it. Asher is a little bit stronger. It's giving them the edge, and there's a good tackle there, but foul called on the edge of the box. Luckily not in the penalty area. But, Kaylee Burrell giving the foul away there. Corner kick to Nashville. Coming up here for Nashville. 35 coming on for number 30. It's Grace Morris replacing Rebecca Campbell. And Chattanooga have number 28 coming on, Reina Flores for Sierra Bowl. Midfielder for midfielder. Now, here we go with the corner kick, swinging in, right across the box. Good header, great save from Caroline Johnson. Good save, Caroline. On the break, what have they got? Number 25, good tackle there. Anna Lounter playing the captain's game tonight for sure, because Molly Grant looking to make a cross. So, corner kick to Nashville. Yuki Vitara to take that one. Are they going to go deep on this one? Everybody's at the far side of the box waiting to receive it. Everyone back for Chattanooga except Brianna Tardo. Swinging it in, it's long, it's a bit too much, and it's out for a goal kick. A bit too much on that one. If you're enjoying the soccer tonight, folks, don't forget the men are here tomorrow night after their trip to California, which was pretty successful during the week. They are here tomorrow night at 7:30 playing Michigan Stars. Always an interesting game when those two get together. So it'll be soccer tonight, soccer tomorrow. What could be better? Clearing the box here, trying to find Hurtado, but when she's fouled from behind, that may be a card. No, just a regular foul, but she actually chipped in the back of the ankle, which usually draws a red card from the referees, telling them to calm down a bit. Chattanooga with a chance to push up here. See if they've got a drill they practiced. Let them get a break on here. They've got three attackers up now. Got Flores, Hurtado and Charco up there. And a quick substitution. Seven for number 16 for Nashville. Ido Kito gets a break. Yukino Wakatsuki comes on. Take her place. Hurtado. Ball out to Reina. Can't get the cross in, but the right idea. Nash will have to push it out for a throw-in. Hurtado taking that one quickly. Cross in, Chaco can't get hold of it. Nash will clear it. Chattanooga keeping the pressure on. This is a good spell of play from Chattanooga. Keeping the pressure on. Two defenders going for the same ball. That's not good. Gives Nash a chance to break. Tari tries to get the cross in. Can't make it happen. This black block dispersed Chattanooga. Nash will get it back from Chattanooga. Taro is looking for those breaks, trying to set the attackers free. Not happening. There's a long ball, trying to find Hurtado, just a bit too strong. But the right idea. Brenna Flores certainly make a difference. Come along, she's really trying to set the targets up and feed the ball up to the attackers. So she has been a good substitution. She's making quite a difference to Chattanooga's attack already. Chattanooga trying to get that ball back. Pushing Nashville back. Nashville staying fairly calm at this point. A little more assertive from Chattanooga. That's good to see. See if they can make something happen here. It's that long ball. Wakatsuki gets the cross in. Pushed out, and I think that's going to trickle out for a throw in. Wakatsuki making Anna Silva work hard. She'll have burnt some calories today for sure. Foul two defenders were a little bit taller than her, so. Shannon with the last chance here into the second minute of extra time. Good long ball, that's great. Can we get hold? Cannot get hold of that. The contact is made, the position's good, just cannot get the last touch on the ball to make the shot. That right idea. Raina Flores up there trying to get the glory. If he's looking at his watch, he should be ready to blow that whistle in a moment. Possession, play that ball back and not do anything risky for the last few seconds of the first half. It's out for a throw into Chattanooga. Gran Hurtado's gone down with a knock. She may be probably waiting for the half-time whistle, and there it is. So that's half-time, folks. Currently standing at 4-0 to Nashville. A rush of goals in the first 18 minutes to play, and put Chattanooga on the back foot. And Nashville took the pressure off a little bit, and Chattanooga tried to come back on that one. Couldn't get another goal in reply, but looking a bit stronger after substitutions made halfway through the first half. So we'll go into the break for 15 minutes, folks. Get yourself a drink. Get yourself cooled down. We'll be right back for this second half of this game on 11 Sports. See you in about 15 minutes. So, half-time, Nashville sitting on a 4-0 lead, and Chattanooga with all to do to come back into the game and get themselves on the score sheet. So with a hat-trick from DePriest in the first half and Molly Grant getting the fourth goal, it's going Nashville's way pretty much as they would hope. Let's see what Chattanooga do in the second half. Thank you for joining us on 11 Sports, bringing you WPSL Soccer, and our sponsor, Louisiana Hot Sauce. Thank you for them for making this possible. Nashville are going to come down the left wing as they did a lot in the first half. Playing Yuki Watari down there quite a lot as one of their stronger players and their main striker. They know where their strengths are. They come again down the left wing. Chattanooga having to fight Alexa Avery, pushing her out for a throw-in for the far side of Chattanooga. Being about 90 degrees, it's cooled down for around 86, but it's still warm, no doubt about that. So expect to have a water break after about 20 minutes. In the meantime, enjoy the soccer. You have to be quick on these. Nashville are very much pressing. Every chance they get, the ball gets away from them, they press to get it back. And that's one of the things that's made them the successful team they are. Chattanooga have to be swift and alert what's around them all the times. Defence and Nashville not holding back on that one. taken. Chattanooga looking to make the break. Getting the numbers back. Each time there's an attack, they get the numbers back. Collision there. Okay, free kick awarded Chattanooga's way. That's a good thing. Some referees don't always catch those, but they caught that one. Jasmine Marquez with the free kick. Here we go, deep in the box, and scuff that one to the left. Did not take advantage of that opportunity there. Cash will get to reset. Physical, which is the way Nashville plays, and Chattanooga have to fight fire with fire and be physical too. And the lands they're running out of real estate to keep the ball in play. Now Watari looking up, nice little touch there. Very confident on the ball. And again, they got Kawaguchi back on for Nashville, who was the linchpin of their midfield. Now Nashville breaking away. Into the side netting with that one. Looked like it had gone in the goal, but only a goal kick. But a good attack again from Nashville. Still dangerous. I don't think they're done yet. Really keen to get a few more goals. De Priest is back on the field too. Maybe wanting to add to her hat trick. Nice touch on there. Collision in the box, nothing given. I don't think that was anything serious, just a coming together of two people in the same bit of space. Molly Grant looking to. Oh, that's a good intercept there from Anna Lanta. Chattanooga trying to. Oh, a sandwich, that's definitely a foul and two player sandwich and attacker. May Pierce getting the crunch in the sandwich there. Scrappy from Nashville. They're getting the ball through. They're not really getting the ball across or onto an attacker, looking a little bit scrappier than the first half. They were more accurate with their passing. coming forward with this. Trapped it in the box, and that slides out for another Chattanooga goal kick. But, Nashville's possession-based soccer is certainly paying off for them. Chattanooga more playing the long ball. Trying to find May Pierce. Throw on the near side again. Great long ball there to Qatari. Pierce, try and get the shot away. Johnson just gets hold of it, goes, bounces around, but she gets hold of it. So, having a busy evening. Mary Elbro in the Nashville keeper's box, not quite so busy. More of a spectator at the moment. Hope that changes. Throw in Nashville's half. See if they can use this for an attack. Nashville goal kick chance for both teams to reset themselves. Back in Chattanooga, stay in Nashville's half instead of being stuck in their own a bit. Goes out for a Chattanooga throw on the near side. An hour played, still 4-0 to Nashville. No goals since the first 18 minutes, and already got exciting. Chattanooga about to make substitution. Damaris Gaines coming on, number 22. May Pierce coming off, and Lauren Wright coming on. Morris Gaines is quite a scorer, so we'll see if she can make a difference to this. Good tackle, solid, no foul given. It's more like it, playing the way that Nashville play, being physical. There we go again. Damaris Gaines goes down. And Angela Stiebel's push. Play goes on. Go back, reshape themselves. helping them. Now Watari has Peyton open. Trying to come through again. Can't be done, but good try. Nashville still with possession. Hitting it long. Johnson picks that one up. Nashville pushing too hard. Still on, sitting on that comfortable lead, of course. Possession here, trying to keep the ball in play. It slides away from Isabel Aguilar. Chanuka playing a little more up the field than before. Trying to be first to the ball there, and that's a Chanuka throw. Some chance to come forward again. Line. passing and just controlling the midfield very well for Nashville. Substitution for Nashville. Molly Grant off. Number 14, Kelly Turf back on. Second run out. Good chance to rotate the players, and I think they may be doing a water break at this point. Let's see. I think they are. It's 20 minutes in, so it's water break time, so folks, get yourself hydrated. Take 2 minutes to reset for the last portion of the game. 70 minutes played still for Nashville. All the action in the first 80 minutes. You missed the first half, where you missed all the fun, but still great to watch the ladies playing. And if you want to watch them playing some more, then two more away games this season before they wrap up the ladies' game. On Sunday up in Knoxville with Tennessee Force, and then Saturday, July 2nd, run down to North Alabama and see them play there. And if you want to see the men tomorrow night, it's the men back at home against Michigan Star, 7:30 Eastern at Finley Stadium. We're bringing that to you live on 11 Sports. And I'll be here for that one too. If you really get tired of the sound of my voice, I recommend going to the CFC Kicks and get yourself a ticket so you can come see it in the stadium and enjoy the atmosphere. If you come with the ladies' game, you can often see the Chattanooga men supporting them too. I've already seen Taylor Gray down there, and I'm looking at Marcus Nagelstadt and Nick Spielman right now, and Alec Reddington too, down there supporting the ladies. So a lot of cross support between the two teams, which is great to see. Out there. West go to the ball, be first to it in Chattanooga. Seeing Nashville do that, Nashville really giving a good example of how to play that kind of soccer. There's a nice touch. Nice run there from Kaylee Burrell. Chattanooga still in possession. Trying to set Avery off on the far side. She gets the cross in, it's really high. And the keeper gets that one. Now the Elber having to finally get busy. Getting carried by MJ Park on it. Not sure they'll throw deep in the Chattanooga half, taken quickly. Can't get it clear. Now they can. Should get the ball back. Cannot keep under control. It slips through Keto Ido's feet. Foul there. referee's liking. Suzuki can't get that one in, but tries hard. She's working hard on that left wing when she came on. too much more time to go. Just run the clock down here, National 2. Not in a hurry. With that comfortable lead, of course. Some tired legs out there too, playing in this heat.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow night on 11 Sports at 7:30. Good night.